Hello everyone. Today I'm going to discuss about whipworm. What is a whipworm? Trichuris, trichura or whipworm causes trichuriasis. That is very common intestinal helminthic infection spread worldwide. The whipworm derives its name from its characteristic whip-like shape. The adult male size is between 30 to 40 mm and female size is between 35 to 50 mm. Buries its thin, thread-like interior half into the intestinal mucosa and feeds on tissue secretions, not blood. This relative tissue invasion causes occasional peripheral eosinophilia. Next slide shows you that whipworm that is present inside the intestine. The cecum and colon are the most commonly infected sites. Although in heavily infected individuals, infection can be present in the more distal segments of the GI tract, that is gastrointestinal tract, such as descending colon and the rectum. The next slide shows the pathophysiology. Trichuris, as with Ascaris lumbricoides, is spread via fecal-oral transmission. Eggs are deposited in soil through human feces. After 10 to 14 days in soil, eggs become invective. In contrast to other parasites such as Ascaris lumbricoides, no tissue migratory phase occurs in Trichuris organisms, confining infection to the GI tract. Larvae hatch in the small intestine where they grow and molt, that is transform, finally taking the residence in the cecum and ascending colon. The time from ingestion of eggs to development of mature worms takes approximately 3 months. Worms may live from 1 to 5 years. And adult female worms lay eggs for about 5 years, shedding up to 20,000 eggs per day. You can see below life cycle of Trichuris trichura. As you can see in the diagram, first the unembryonated eggs are passed into feces. The second stage is the cell stage, then is the advanced cleavage stage, third stage, then in the fourth stage the embryonated eggs are ingested, fifth larvae hatch in small intestine, and then sixth stage where adults are produced in the cecum. The infective stage are the fourth stage where the embryonated eggs are ingested. The diagnostic stage is the first stage, that is unembryonated eggs that is passed in feces. Next, coming to the symptoms. Most individuals with whipworm infection are asymptomatic. Clinical symptoms are limited to patients with heavy infection. No pulmonary migration or extra gastrointestinal symptoms. Nocturnal loose stools, dysentery can occur in patients with greater than 200 worms, rectal prolapse, failure to thrive, symptoms of anemia, vague abdominal discomfort and stunted growth. So these are the symptoms of the patients with whipworm infection. If you want more details about whipworm or you have any doubts and queries, you can write below in the mention in the comment. I'll make separate slides for them individually. If you like this video, please hit the like button and subscribe to this channel. Thank you very much. Have a nice day.